So I will just tell you good morning everyone, because this is the class for general English, and all those who are not present today, they can study from here. In your general English, most of the grammar portion is from what you have already studied throughout your childhood in school, that is active, passive, direct, indirect, verbs and tenses. A new thing which is introduced is the transcription of the sounds, means how the sound would be written, what are the symbols to write a particular sound. That is a new thing introduced for you. Otherwise, most of the grammar portion, as well as writing an application or letter writing and writing a paragraph, that is all which you have already done in your 10th and 12th. So this is something which is already done by you. The new thing is the chapters which are introduced in general English for you in first year. So because this would be a passing subject, like your marks will not be added in the percentage. And as Sapna has just asked that whether the Anandam marks would be added in general English, so no, not at all. Anandam subject, as I have many times told you while we had Anandam Day celebration, that Anandam is a separate subject, and it is an additional subject added to you from this year. It is of 100 marks, and the marks obtained in this would be added in your total overall percentage. While general English, general Hindi, environment and computer marks are only for passing. If you get 36 out of 100 in these subjects, you will pass, and the marks are not added in your overall percentage. So how many subjects would make your percentage? Three subjects which you have already taken, like for example English literature, drawing and painting, or public ed, plus one which is added new, that is Anandam. So out of 400, your percentage would be calculated. And general Hindi, general English, they are all for passing marks only. So this is for clarity of all students who will be coming preparing for general English, and this is the class we are holding today. And I would like to read from this beautiful poem, and there is a purpose that why a particular subject is included in your syllabus. So as girls or as boys, if it would have been a boys' college also, everybody should know about the gender bias free society. And this poet, as I've always told you, that first of all you should know the title of the poem or the prose, whatever you're writing. So the title is Voice of the Unwanted Girl. So this is the name of the poem. Who is the poet? Sujata Bhatt. So before moving on, let us find out who is this Sujata Bhatt. So Sujata Bhatt was born in Ahmedabad. Where is Ahmedabad? There are many geography students, so I expected them to know otherwise also. A graduate, she had done her graduation from Writers' Workshop University of Iowa. She has been called one of the finest poets alive today. Voice of the Unwanted Girl, as the title states, is the articulation, expression, putting something into words. Voice of the Unwanted Girl, as the title states, is the articulation of a victim girl child who questions the inhumanity and horror of female infanticide. Now, in this line, you will find some difficult words. Articulation means expression, putting into words what and of whom? Of a victim girl child. Victim, somebody who has been tortured, who is at the mercy of others. Girl child who questions the inhumanity. One was the concept we were studying, humanitarianism. This is inhumanity, opposite of humanitarianism, where we do not consider other as a human, and we treat the other person as if that person does not have human feelings. So inhumanity and horror of female infanticide. So this is an important word, female infanticide. What does this mean? Infanticide. Side means killing. Infant means newborn baby. So the killing of the newborn baby. Who is this baby? A girl child. We do not kill the boy child. You must have listened to or heard about or read in the newspapers about small little infant babies, newly born, or womb which has not even fully developed, which is called feticide. Fetus is the developing child. So they come to know through the test that what is the sex of the gender of that developing child. If it is a female and the family does not want, then we found that they would abort the child. Infanticide is the girl child is born and then that would not be, either it would be given away or it would be killed, because the society thinks it is happening in India, because we think that girls, unwanted child, voice of the unwanted girl. So why is this feeling? Sujata Bhatt in this poem is trying to painfully express, you will find that how she would bring out the horror of this act of killing the girl children. That and through poetry, such emotions can be very easily expressed, though it's a very crude, very harsh and horrifying act. Voice of the so the poem taken from the anthology. This would be a question important. From where is the poem taken? It is taken from the anthology. Anthology means a collection of a book which has a collection of poems. That's an anthology by the same writer. My mother's way of wearing a sari. So the main book is by Sujata Bhatt, My mother's way of wearing a sari. And from this, one poem has been taken, that is Voice of the Unwanted Girl. We're written with rare sensitivity and social concern, critiques patriarchy. So these are the new words coming up. You must note down what is the meaning of the word patriarchy. Do you know these words? Like infanticide, the another word which has come is patriarchy. So here again, in order to understand the meaning of the word, what you should do is that divide or split the word patriarchy. What we can do is, we can just divide this word into two, patri and archy. So the word archy means rule, okay? And the word patri has been originated from the word patr, which is father, okay? So it means the rule of the father. Matriarchy, matri means mother, archy means rule, so the rule of the mother, which happens in some states in the southern parts of India also. So here the poet is trying to talk about the problems which come up because of the thought of the society that the father will rule the household. The mother and the girls, they have to follow the rule of the father. Because of that, the girls are not wanted. They are considered to be a burden, or the other problems related to them, because of that, people want to do away with the child. So patriarchy and demands for a world in which gender discriminations are erased. Discrimination, do you find this word familiar now? Yesterday we talked about, in the chapter democracy, the word discrimination had come up, for that people are discriminated against each other because of their caste, because of their race, because of other things. So gender also. So if you understand, if you focus on the word, they will repeat, because the sea of world is limited. most of the words will be repeated here and there again and again. But if we focus once on them, again you will strike, oh, I had heard this about this word in another chapter. So discrimination against women, that is gender discrimination. Gender means related to the sex, or whether it's a male or a female. So the writer or the poet Sujata Bhatt, in this poem Voice of the Unwanted Girl, talks about this gender discrimination, that it should be erased. What is an erased? From eraser. Eraser, what does the eraser do? Rub, remove. Erased to remove the gender discriminations. So with this we have understood about the basic introduction to the poem, and we will now study soon the actual poem.